Sometimes I live under the moon. I thank God I'm breathing. And I pray, don't take me soon, 'cause I am here for a reason.
Sometimes in my tears I drown, but I never let it get me down. So when negativity surrounds, I know someday it'll all turn around. Because all my life I've been waiting for, I've been praying for, for the people to say that we don't wanna fight no more. There'll be no more war, and our children will pay.
I talk about Israel. Can we love Israel if we don't love ourselves? How it's come? If you don't love your brother, can you love your enemy? It's how it's come. So this is why we try now to bring unity and to love each other as Christian all together. Yes, I will share with you my testimony. Okay. In 83, I finished my school. And in the time that it was time of danger, because it was the beginning of Intifada, first Intifada. And in our time, it was no work, and we finished the school and we don't have anything. And I fall in drugs. I was using drugs, heroin and cocaine for 10 years. In 93, God opened the door for me and I go to Haifa, to a center. They call it House of Victory, or Beit Nitzachon in Hebrew. And this place, it's have a calling to put Arab and Jewish together. For me, it was hard and difficult. It was the beginning of Intifada, and it was the hatred and the anger was on the table. It was not covered anymore. It was on the table. And it was war. First Intifada, it was war. I had a lot of hatred for the Jewish. And I go through it for many years. I was using drugs and I was also with this part of doing. I am not afraid to talk about it now. It was before I was afraid so much to talk about it. But I believe I go through this because God wants to show me other things. But God changed me, and this is what I am so happy with it. And here I can talk proud about it, that the most important, God take my stone heart and He give my flesh heart to love my enemy.
Some things on our side and some things on their side. Palestinian side is in disarray, and I don't subscribe to the notion that there's no one to talk to on the other side. But it isn't clear that there is a partner who's completely in control with whom we can sit down and make progress. So, unfortunately, they do need to get their house in order a bit. But more importantly, and more in the realm of our responsibility, there's a lot for us to do. I think that Israelis are not sufficiently aware and sensitive to the suffering current and past of the Palestinian people. I think that we need to be more forthcoming and more conciliatory towards the Palestinians. I think that we need to work towards a two-state solution in which the vast, vast, vast majority of the West Bank becomes Palestine, along with, of course, all of Gaza. And that the settlers need to be removed from there, and Israel needs to do some things that will be very unpopular with large segments of its population, and make some very difficult decisions and implement them, make them and implement them, in order to be able to give the Palestinians a reasonable offer and make peace. And putting a face to the other side, I think, is very, very important. So the face-to-face encounter.
Number one, the crisis has to be brought under control. You've got to have zero tolerance for violence, terror, incitement, and zero tolerance for settlement activity. You've got to have an active resumption of negotiations between Israelis and Palestinians. And that's not going to happen without the international community, and particularly the administration in Washington, being engaged on that. And finally, once those talks resume, this ain't nuclear science. We know what a final status agreement looks like, and this has to be articulated by both friends of Israel and friends of Palestine. Namely, two-state solution, a politically divided Jerusalem, a resolution of the refugee problem. We know how to do it. What's missing is not a lack of knowledge about how to solve the conflict, but a lack of political will. And we're going to be needing leadership in Israel and Palestine, but we'll also need leadership from Washington and friends of Israelis and Palestinians throughout the world.